Capital Community Television, in cooperation with Salem Kaiser Schools, presents Greater Valley Conference High School Volleyball. Tonight's match features the McNary Celtics visiting the West Salem Titans. Hi, everybody. I'm Alan Bushong, and I'm here with Susie Armstrong, and we are here for truly the match of the season with the conference championship on the line.
Yes, is it definitely on the line. McNary's lost twice to West Albany. West Albany's lost twice to West Salem. And West Salem's lost once to McNary. So a win for the Titans is a league championship.
And otherwise, they're finishing a three-way tie. Before we talk a little bit about the teams, how do you resolve a three-way tie?
I really don't know. I think they might just give a tri-championship since it's the state tournament's based totally on power rankings.
Well, you've seen West Salem play a lot. We've seen them once this year in a very sound defeat of West Albany. We've seen McNary also soundly defeating South Salem. They're both tall. They both can move the ball. They both can block. They can pass to the front line. What do you expect to see tonight from both teams, Susie?
I think it's going to be a really exciting match. There's going to be some big booming hitting going on, and I think defense is going to be key on this. Who's going to keep the ball and play longer? Who's going to pass serve better? And then who's going to win the big points when it matters? And when you have to have the point, who's going to have the steadiness to do that?
Well, as a former coach, and we always hear this from the coach, it all starts with the pass. How have these teams been passing in the second half of the season?
Much better than the first half, but, you know, it's a big match, and a little bit of nerves does affect that. But both teams have got to get that ball pushed up past the attack line to their setters so they can run an offense. They both have really great dynamic hitters in all three positions, but it's tough to deliver a ball if it's not getting up there.
Who should we be watching on McNary? Who has impressed you on McNary?
Well, definitely their middle hitter, Vanessa Hayes, and they've been playing her around. She hits a little bit outside, a little middle, a little right side. Kelly Scholl does a great job of a little deception on the offense, so that will be fun to watch her hit there. So,
on the West Salem side of the ball, who do we watch in West Salem? Obviously, Paige Whipple. A little bit about Paige and who else?
Well, Paige Whipple, just watching her warm up just now, she's pretty fired up about this match. She's hitting some big ones. She's got game. But Casey Campbell, playing opposite her, is doing a great job. And Delaney Smith's a really solid middle for us.
We're really glad that you can join us. We like it when you support high school sports. High school girls volleyball improved so much in the 25 years of CCTV telecast. Great that you're going to see what should be a fabulous game. And we'll be back with the introduction to the lineups right after this message.
Support for tonight's program was provided by MAPS Credit Union, premier sponsor of Salem Kaiser Schools. Visit one of our 9 convenient locations in the Willamette Valley or our website, mapscu.com. By Les Schwab Tire Centers, doing the right thing since 1952. Experience the Les Schwab difference at your neighborhood Les Schwab Tire Center or visit us on the web at lesschwab.com. And by Wallery's Premium Pizza in West Salem. Old-fashioned pizza at an old-fashioned price. Located at 1555 Edgewater Street Northwest, phone 503-362-6858.
And now, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First for the visitors, the Celts of McNary High School. The Celts are coached by Kelly Scholl. Starting tonight for the Celts, number 5, 6-foot junior Sydney Hunter. Number 7, 5'8 senior Madison Cloyd. Number 10, 6'1" senior Kaylee Flores. Number 11, 5'10" senior Maddie Hingston. Number 13, 6'2" senior Raina Strand. Number 15, 6' senior Vanessa Hayes. And in the libero position tonight, wearing number 21, 5'5" senior Kylie Gilmore. And now, the starters for your West Salem Titans is announced by head coach Katie Herber. Starting for the Titans, number 2, 5'8" junior Casey Campbell. Number 4, 5'9" junior Kayla Bain. Number 5, 5'7" junior Ashley Orr. Number 6, 6'2" junior Delaney Smith. Number 10, 5'10" junior Maddie Kelly. Number 12, 6'2" junior Paige Whipple. And starting for the Titans in the libero position, number 17, 5'3" sophomore Keaton Page. Officials for tonight's game are from the Salem Volleyball Officials Association. Your R1 in the up position is Brian Land, and the R2 on the floor is Dave Haggerty. Linesmen for tonight are Brian Kuhn and Justin Kramer.
Casey Campbell, one of the two outside hitters, will be serving first for West Salem to touch off this match. And an ace for Casey Campbell. Great way for the Titans to start. A kill by Paige Whipple. Assist by Maddie Kelly. Casey's going after Hayes. And Delaney Smith, a kill in the middle. That's gonna set the tone, as if West Salem can establish their middle, then we're gonna be okay. The Celtics need to get a good pass and an attack from a good opportunity for the Celtics to capitalize. Coming into the game is the libero, Kylie Gilmore. And a little miscue on the middle there with Smith. Must have called a touch on that play. So, Ashley Moisen in for the Titans, setting. And Kelly in the net for the Titans, side out to the Celtics. Coming into the game, Sam Voorhees and Shaylee Williams. Serving will be Voorhees. Both teams a little out of system right here. Nice little tip. And attacking of the middle. Middle seems to be a weak spot for most teams. Whipple tapes it deep. Nice attack by Hayes. Good scramble by the Titans in defense. And a great back, deceptive back set for the setter and Kaylee Flores with a kill on the right side. Setter did a good job of hiding that set. Hayes did a good job of selling it. Whipple with the kill. Coming into the game for the Titans is Kimber Rabigo. Maddie Kelly serving for the Titans. She has three hitting options now. Whipple hits into a big block. Good block and a side out for the Celtics. Okay, coming into the game for the Celtics is Jaylene Montano to serve for them. Back row attack is a little out by the Titans. One of the key things for this big of a match is the passing on serve, and both teams are struggling a little bit trying to get that ball past the attack line for the setters to run some options. Whipple serving for the Titans. Another tough, good attack by Montano. Gil. And a great push to the back corner by Hayes for the Celtics. Coming back into the game is Raina Strand for the Celtics. Celtics are serving tough. Good dig by Whipple. And Hayes a little out on the back row attack. Coming back in to the game is Delaney Smith for the Titans. Serving for the Titans is Keaton Page, the libero. And Campbell just had a too far outside set, hits it into the antenna. Back into the game is Sydney Hunter and Madison Cloyd. Cloyd serving for the Celtics. Good pass by Whipple. Yes. It's a good play. And the Celtics get the side out. Good attack, little off speed that really keeps the Titans back on their heels. Nary's got their biggest lead of this night right now with Cloyd serving. Good pass by Casey Campbell and a little bit long. Needs to be a little bit higher set to Whipple. She's a little tall. She's got to be able to swing that arm freely. Coach Herbert calling a timeout, trying to get her girls settled down. Probably talking about watching that off speed. They're doing a good job of attacking the middle. The Celtics are doing a good job of attacking the middle of the court, going to some corners. They're really going heavy to Vanessa Hayes. She's their big hitter. They're using her both in the front row and the back row on the attack and is doing a great job there. Key to the Titans getting back in this match is they definitely have to pass serve a little bit better and push that ball up past the attack line. That's that white line, 10 feet off of the net, so that the girls can, so that Kelly has some options when she's setting. Cloyd is there for the Celtics here. Great angle shot by Casey Campbell. Kill for the Titans. That was a good timeout by Coach Herber. Anytime you get a take a timeout and you get a side out, that's a good timeout. Into the game now is Ashley Orr to serve for the Titans. And a good tip right over the block. Side out to the Celtics. Coming back into the game for the Celtics is Kaylee Flores. Maddie Hingston will be serving for the Celtics. Trying to hide Paige, but she ends up taking it. Nice back row attack by Whipple. Right to that corner. It's a tough corner to play defense on. Well placed. Starting the second half, or the second rotation through, is Casey Campbell serving. Campbell hits into the block. She tooled it. It's called making the block do some error, and they blocked it out of bounds. So that was actually Whipple, excuse me. Campbell still back to serve. Gilmore thought about taking that. Good thing. Anytime your hands are over your head, you probably don't want to jump and try and pass it when you're in the back row. It's definitely going to be out. Gilmer serving for the Celtics, playing in the libero position. Good pass by Whipple. And a little wide for Smith for the Titans. Good pass by Campbell and Smith. Tools right off of Hayes for a nice kill out of the middle. Wave showing some confidence by Kelly with her middle hitter with Smith. Hit it a little wide and then came back and got the kill. Now into the game is Ashley Moisson. She'll be serving for the Titans. Nice deep serve, but a good pass. And Hayes, kill into that deep one corner. Little miss hit, but sometimes it really doesn't matter how you hit it if you get the kill. Nobody knows other than you got a kill. Back into the game for the Celtics is Sam Voorhees. And great arm by Whipple, just a little bit wide on that. She had a single blocker, nice fast tempo. That's what the Titans need to get back into this game.
And that time she put it away. Good kill by Whipple. Back into the game for the Titans is Kimber Rabigo. Serving for the Titans is Maddie Kelly. Good pass. Just a little miscue between the setter and the middle there. And Hayes shows what she can do. Nice angle out of the middle, nice quick attack. Back into the game is Jaylene Montana. Good pass by Campbell. Whipple mixing it up a little bit, and Hayes attacking. Good coverage. And Kayla Bain with an attack out of the middle. Titans are doing a really good job of mixing up their hitters. It's kind of confusing the blockers on the Celtic side. Whipple to serve for the Titans. Good deep pass, or serve, excuse me. Little miss on by Campbell. So Hayes goes back to the back row to serve for the Celtics. Gilmore back into the match for the Celtics, as is Keaton Page. So both liberos are back in the game, wearing similar colors. Page is serving. Oh. Kill by Shaylee Williams. Nice down the line from that right side. It's really tough to hit that shot, and she did a good job of that. Made Whipple have to really reach and try and dig that up. Now serving for the Celtics is Madison Cloyd. Smith did a good job with the low set, pushing that right to the middle. For a kill and a side out for the Titans. Back into the game for the Titans is Ashley Orr, and she'll be serving for the Titans. Good pass by Gilmore. And big kill by Hunter. She did a great job, great fast arm. Down the line into that deep corner. Really tough to defend. Now serving for Maddie Hingston. Good pass by Whipple and a great attack by Smith, assisted by Kelly. That was good side out. Well done, well executed. When you get that pass right to the setter, you can do it. You have a lot of options. When the setter's scrambling to set, it limits what you can do. Campbell serving for the Titans. Hunter, all she could do was tip it. Big back row attack by Campbell. And setter didn't quite release, didn't transition fast enough, and called for a double. Titans within one right now. Good pass. And a little long by Hunter, ties it up. So the Titans got down a little bit, but are now right back in the thick of it. It's a 6-point game here. And a block that's outside. They're calling it that it was blocked out of bounds. The line judge called a touch, but I think he was calling the touch off of the block. So back is Gilmore to serve. Campbell pushes it. And a good angle shot by Whipple to side it out. When the game gets this tight, it's a game of errors. Who's going to make the fewest errors is probably going to win this match. So, and this set at 20-20. Moisten to serve for the Titans. Celtics out of system. All Hayes can do is just kind of reach and shoot. Whipple's attacking that angle. Great save. Oh, almost. Great hustle by Maddie Hingston to try and keep that ball in play. She just didn't get it back in the court enough. Whipple's finding the angle to be a pretty nice place to hit right now. They're good pass by Hingston, and they're going to take it. And Whipple hits it just a little bit long. So it's still tied up at 21. Back into the game for the Celtics is Sam Voorhees and Shaylee Williams. Got a tall front line here for the Celtics. Titans have a setter in the front row. The Celtics have three hitters. Good pass. Great attack by Bain out of the middle. And a great dump on two by Kelly. That, you know, most teams are expecting three hits, and taking it on two really keeps the defense kind of scattered a little bit. So it was an opportune time for Kelly to do that. Kelly serving for the Titans. Good pass. And a little tight on the set for Kaylee Flores. She's in the net on the attack after the attack. Titans have a 2-point lead now, and Coach Scholl is going to call a timeout and settle these girls down. This is a big serve for the Titans, and the Celtics really need to figure out how they're going to side this out to keep them within reach. It's either a 1-point or a 2-point swing here, or a 3-point swing. Okay. So here a nice back set, and Flores just keeps going into the net. So she had too much forward momentum. The set was a little bit tight, so she didn't have many options. She tried to take that swing, but just kept going, couldn't keep out of the net. Now in collegiate and club ball, that would have been okay because she only touched the bottom part of the net. But in, here in the high school with Federation rules, it's a little different. Nice deep serve by Kelly, and they're out of system, and Hayes hits just a little long. Setter was unable to attack or to get her hands on that ball, and so have set point for the Titans here. And an opportune serve by Kelly and an ace to have the Titans take the first set, 25-21. So teams will switch sides. We'll see what side's the lucky side here, or if they're both lucky.
Support for tonight's program was provided by MAPS Credit Union, premier sponsor of Salem-Keizer Schools. Visit one of our convenient locations in the Willamette Valley or our website, mapcu.com. By Les Schwab Tire Centers, doing the right thing since 1952. Experience the Les Schwab difference at your neighborhood Les Schwab Tire Center or visit us on the web at lesschwab.com. And by Wallery's Premium Pizza in West Salem, old-fashioned pizza at an old-fashioned price. Located at 1555 Edgewater Street Northwest, phone 503-362-6858.
Serving for the Celtics is Maddie Hingston. And Whipple out of the back row, off of the block, and a kill. A good side out for the Titans. A good way to start the second set. Serving for the Titans is Casey Campbell. She's done a good job of serving for the Titans tonight. I think I just jinxed her. Served it a little bit outside. Hayes coming back into the game for the Celtics, and going back to serve is Kylie Gilmore. Titans are in a two-person serve receive with just Whipple and Campbell. Whipple does a good job of pushing it, a little too, and too much right, and Campbell misses on that back row attack. So when there's only two passers, the server can kind of work that ball around and hope that the passers have to work a little bit. She's kind of serving it right to them, and Smith sold that one for Whipple. So Smith went up, held a blocker, and Whipple went one-on-one with a blocker and just hit a great angle shot for a kill and a side out. Coming into the game is Ashley Moisen for the Titans, and she will serve. A little interesting back set dump, and Whipple is finding her rhythm. She's doing a great job, and the Celtics have better do something to not let Kelly deliver that ball to Whipple. And a good block between Kelly and Bain to block Hayes. You're going to change up this serve receive a little bit, the Celtics are. Moisten serves it a little too deep. Coming back into the game for the Celtics is Sam Voorhees and Shaylee Williams. Van Voorhees will serve. Kelly did a good job with a mediocre pass. Anytime you deliver it to Whipple right now, she's found a rhythm. She's probably going to have a pretty good swing on it. And back into the game is Kimber Rabigo. Back to serve for the Titans is Maddie Kelly. And Williams. Good deep hit, and the dig was right into the net. Didn't have a lot.